I'm here to promote my province. I work for a tourism promotion agency for the province of KwaZulu-Natal in South Africa. So basically our aim is to meet outbound tour operators and engage them to firstly build relationship and for new ones to introduce our region and just make sure that they continue to sell and market our region.
So if you were going to sell your region to me, how would you do that? What is the big things about your region?
Well, I think, you know, Africa, being Africa, you know, there's many, many things. I mean, our region is obviously along the east coast of Africa. It's blessed with many, many natural attractions. But basically, firstly, in the name KwaZulu-Natal, you know, everyone knows Zulu. So basically, we come with a very strong Zulu heritage. And I think people wanting to know more about Zulu would want to come and trace back the origins and the whole history that's related to that. From a heritage point of view, we've got South Africa's first World Heritage Site, and which basically is called Isimangaliso Wetlands Park. And also, we have a very steep heritage within where that's where the battlefields took place. Firstly, the Anglo-Boer War that took place in our province, as well as the Anglo-Zulu War, because remember, the English also fought the Zulus, you know, which was the fight for power. So we've got very deep heritage. Mandela also has a very strong heritage in our province. Firstly, that's where he was captured. You'll see the movie that's going to be coming out now, Mandela, which is Long Walk to Freedom. He was actually arrested in our province, and there's a Mandela capture statue that's actually been built. Very iconic, because it's actually 27 poles that don't look anything like a statue until you stand in a particular position, and then you actually realize, oh, that's actually Mandela. And also, his achievement of freedom actually happened in our province, because that's where he actually voted for the first time after spending 27 years, and there is actually that bit of history. From an adventure point of view, we also boast the highest peak in terms of the Southern Africa, which is the Drakensberg-Gahlamba region, and therefore we believe we offer a lot of adventure experiences for those that want to explore the adrenaline. They can drive up Sunny Pass, which is a very interesting part where, you know, all the 4x4 enthusiasts or off-road enthusiasts would like to drive up the Sunny Pass. I mean, it's just one of those drives that you want to do before you die. And obviously, we are a port province. Therefore, we've got warm beaches that are safe to swim, warm water as well. The UK has got a lot of affinity with our destination because of the steep heritage. We have a very huge presence of people who are of UK origin, but we're finding that also we're picking up on other new markets, the Brazilians, the Chinese, and all coming in, but it's all growing off a small base compared to our traditional market, which is UK, Germany. The other market that's actually done very well for us is actually the USA market, and there they have a love for heritage, as well as obviously adventure that would include safari. We're picking up a lot of cruise market also, because obviously Durban being the port city, we're picking up a lot of cruise people that are doing the fly cruise experience, because then it becomes convenient for them to cruise along the east coast of Africa. We've got cruise liners that have repositioned themselves for seasonal, and also they can do a mixture then of safari and cruise, which is something that you don't do in some other cruise destinations.